we go. That says just arrived in Quito after a 12-hour flight. How does it feel like?
Horrendous.
Yeah. We're looking fresh, obviously. Had a quite an interesting off-road Jeep journey to get here. We've had to climb under a barbed wire fence to get here. No casualties so far. So here we go. Yes, girls.
So guys, this is the summit, 4,199 meters. We made it!
Yes, RT! Woo!
Our jubilant moment was quickly overshadowed by a hailstorm.
Cold, damp.
We got a nice wet sandwich.
But we made it to the top.
We did.
Snacks, water, little scarves to cover our necks from the sun. SPF 100 on me. I didn't even realize it was a thing.
We're hiking up sand, which means every step we take, we fall back another half step.
I feel a bit sick. The air is very thin. I've got slightly blurred vision. But I'm seemingly the most determined I've ever felt in my life. We will get there.
Summit of Pichincha.
Woohoo!
Made it up. 22 out of 23. It's not too bad.
Everyone did really well. Bit of a scramble towards the end, which is always a bit of fun.
Which is basically just rock climbing.
But yeah, it might as well be rock climbing. We'll make it sound better than what it is.
So, we just scaled. Ginger. On the way down, we did a bit of hill skiing, bulk through volcanic ash.
That was fun.
A lot of fun. And we're now sat in the cable car and we're waiting
fine
for
as well.
Yep, for a beautiful meal.
We have 4 hours of walking ahead of us to get to the base camp where we will rest, eat, sleep until tomorrow morning, and at 5 a.m. tomorrow we will begin our summit attempt of that mountain over there.
How are you feeling, Kate?
Oh, good. On our way to the refuge. We're an hour in exactly. Yeah, so good. The rain's just starting. Got the harness, got the hat, all the gear, and no idea is what this is called.
So we made it to the refuge. Look at the weather. Not great. It's snowing and it's absolutely freezing up here.
So yesterday we had to climb up with our day packs plus our hiking gear for the next day plus our sleeping bags plus our groovy helmets. Harness. So it was a lot of extra kit, probably an extra 5 to 7 kilos than we're used to, and the conditions were insane. It was one of the toughest, most grueling hikes I think I've ever done. It was just relentless. First came the rain, then came the hail, then came the icy wind, and it just seemed to go on and on and on. We finally got to the refuge and it was packed. I think potentially some people that weren't supposed to be in there. So we ended up squeezing 27 people into about 20 beds, maybe less. So not a great night's sleep all around. And then we set off at 5:30 this morning with a view to attempting the summit. But after much deliberation between the local guides here, they decided that the conditions were not suitable and it was too dangerous to even attempt to continue up to the summit. So instead we are hiking to a lake that's on the mountain, and actually the conditions have started to clear up, but if you can see the lake in the background, there's not too many complaints from the group as this is an alternative to going up to the summit.
To the Cotopaxi National Park. It's about 9 o'clock in the morning. It's going to take us around 45 minutes to an hour to walk up to the refuge on Cotopaxi, and then another further 2 hours to walk up to the glacier line where the team will do all their training. So here we go for another day. Well, it looks like we could have got to the highest point that we could do today. They're just testing the snow. But there is a big avalanche risk here.
I'm so scared!
Yeah. How are you, Amy?
Scary, scary. We made it this far. We climbed over a really scary crevasse.
Multiple crevasses.
We're here.
Yeah.
So we're on our way back to the refuge now after attempting to summit Cotopaxi, which was ultimately unsuccessful in terms of making it to the summit, but you know, we expected that to be the case from the off. A little bit of false hope perhaps when we set off because the conditions were actually quite nice, but the damage had already been done. The snow was just too deep to trek through. We did a valiant attempt and we got just beyond 5,500 meters, which is where the group that had to turn around yesterday also failed. So really proud of myself and the rest of the team for getting as far as we did. It was a fairly grueling trek on the glacier, but yeah, really worthwhile. Really proud of everyone. Looking forward to second breakfast now.
We've just got back to the refuge after a bit of a hellish journey.
Yeah.
Crevasses, lots of snow in the dark,
yeah.
And then we had to turn back because the snow was too much. We would have been snowballs at the bottom of the hill.
We got the 550, which is a really good achievement. We couldn't have gone any further, guys wouldn't let us go any further, so we've done all we could. It was one of the most difficult things I've ever done. One of the scariest things I've ever done, going over them crevasses.
Oh, yeah. The crevasses are so scary.
And it was in the dark.
Feeling super proud though, right?
Yeah,
really proud.
Very proud.
Very proud.
things aren't looking too great. The weather is horrendous, as you can see. Hail starting to fall down on us as we were driving up from Cotopaxi. Our guide was surprised at how low the snow was on the mountain. We're due to stay at 5,300 metres tonight at the base camp. But speaking to the guides, I reckon that's going to be a challenge just with the snow and the weather. We're still going to try and crack on and do that, but weather might be the issue and the fact that we can't do it.
So, against all the odds, and in spite of the weather conditions, we've made it to the refuge at Chimborazo. We're about to set off on a hike to the high camp, 5,300 meters. It's gonna be dark by the time we get there, so we've got our torches. We're gonna have a little bit of food, try and get some sleep, and then set off on what is very much an unknown adventure later on tonight, tomorrow morning. So we're halfway up to the high camp, and I think the decision has been taken by the guides that it's too dangerous to continue. There's so much snowfall. There's not usually snow on this part of the mountain. It's too dangerous. What's the risk, Liam?
Storm, thunderstorm about to come in, closing. We need to get out of here, he said, as quick as possible.
As quick as possible. Right, well, we better stop this video and get off this mountain.
Yep.
I've never descended a mountain so fast. There was a storm, electric storm. I got down, I was hyperventilating. But we're back safe. As you can see, everyone's coming in. We were walking down and my helmet and head torch was had loads of static in it. My phone on my leg started to get warm. Oh my God. If you didn't think this was a challenge, now you do. No matter what anybody says about getting to the top of a summit, that was by far the scariest moment I've ever had in a mountain.
So this is us on our last day in Ecuador, last full day. We're gonna be spending it in a spa, relaxing, swimming, and chilling out in this naturally heated water. What can be better after a week of walking and pain and rain and cold?
Here's to us and to raising all the money for the Prince's Trust. Cheers. Cheers, everyone. Cheers.